Hey there, Angular folks, it's Brian. After many years of building with Angular, I'm here to help you level up your skills and build better apps. Your UI probably treats every user exactly the same, and it might be driving them crazy. Keyboard users get identical experiences to mouse users. Your code programmatically focuses elements and triggers the same aggressive responses as intentional user actions. The Angular CDK's FocusMonitor can detect exactly how users interact with any element: mouse clicks, keyboard navigation, touch, or programmatic focus. And I'll bet 90% of Angular developers have never heard of it. Today, I'll show you how this one service creates adaptive user experiences that respond intelligently to different interaction patterns. Let's dive in. All right, let's start by exposing the problem. I've got what looks like a simple email input field, but watch what happens when we interact with it in different ways. First, let's click into the field. Then let's click outside to blur the field. Boom, error message appears. That seems reasonable for a mouse user, right? Now let me refresh and try something different. This time, I'm going to tab into the field using my keyboard, the way screen reader users, power users, and anyone following accessibility best practices might navigate. Then I'll tab away. Again, the error shows up immediately. But here's where things get problematic. Watch what happens when I click this focus email button, which programmatically focuses the input field. That error message is still staring at us. This might seem fine, but it's actually a problem. Think about it. If our code is automatically focusing this field, maybe as part of a form validation flow or user guidance, we probably don't want to spam the user with error messages. That's just a bad user experience. What we really want here is smart validation that behaves differently based on how the user focused the field. And that's exactly what the Angular CDK Focus Monitor can help us achieve. Let's switch to our component HTML to see what we're dealing with. Looking at our template, this is pretty standard stuff. Here's our input element with a template reference variable called email input. We'll need that in a moment. Notice this blur event that calls an onBlur method. This is our current validation trigger, and it's the source of our one-size-fits-all problem. The input uses ng model to bind to an email signal, which is how we're storing the value the user types. This input gets an error class when a show error signal is true, which provides visual feedback. Below that, we have our error message that only shows when the show error signal is true. That's this if block. And finally, here's our button that focuses the input using that template reference variable, simulating what your application might do to guide users. Now let's switch to the component TypeScript to see the logic behind this. Here, we have our show error signal initialized to false, no errors by default. We have our email signal initialized to an empty string. Remember, that's where we store what the user types. And here's our onBlur function. Pretty straightforward. It checks if we have an invalid email using this helper method. And if so, it sets the show error signal to true. This validation itself is super simple, just looking for an at symbol. Obviously, you'd want something more robust in production, but this works for our demo. The problem is this function has no idea how the user focused the field. Mouse click, keyboard navigation, touch gesture, programmatic focus, it treats them all identically. So here's what we want to achieve instead. When a user tabs into the field with their keyboard or clicks with their mouse and then leaves the field, if it's invalid, we want to show the error message. If it's valid, we want to make sure the error is hidden. But here's the key difference. If our code programmatically focuses the field, like when someone clicks that focus email button, we don't want to show any error messages. And in fact, if the error message is already showing, we want to hide it. This is where the Angular CDK Focus Monitor service comes into play. It can tell us exactly how an element received focus, which lets us create smarter, more user-friendly validation. First, quick note. you'll need the Angular CDK installed. Run this command in your project root. But we already have it installed in our demo project, so we're good to go. Okay, I'm going to start by injecting the FocusMonitor service from the CDK Ally module using Angular's inject function. Next, let's add a constructor. Then we need to add an effect. Within this effect, we can use the FocusMonitor service to monitor the focus state with the monitor function. This monitor method needs an element ref to monitor focus on. In our case, that's our email input. So I'll use Angular's new view child signal function to get a reference to it. This creates a signal that will hold a reference to the element with the template reference variable email input. Then we can pass this element to our monitor function. Now, this returns an observable, so I need to subscribe to it. But first, let me add proper cleanup using take until destroyed. I also need to inject destroy ref for this to work, and then pass it to the take until destroyed function. Okay, now we're ready to subscribe. Now, let me explain what this observable gives us. The result will be a focus origin. This observable fires every time focus on the element changes. When the element gets focused, we'll receive mouse for mouse clicks, keyboard for tab navigation or arrow key movements, touch for touch events on mobile devices, or program when our code focuses it programmatically. When the element loses focus, we get null. What we want to do in the example is track the last origin state for some of our logic. Let me add a new signal for that. We'll use the focus origin interface for this signal since that's what we get from the observable. Now, I'll set this signal in our subscription. Also, let me temporarily comment out the onBlur method so we can see the focus monitor in action. Let's switch to the HTML and add a way to see what's happening behind the scenes. To do this, I'll add a paragraph that shows the current focus origin. If it's null, I'll display none to make it crystal clear. Okay, let's save and see this in action. Perfect. When I click into the field, it shows mouse as the focus origin. When I blur, it shows none because focus was lost. When I tab into the field, boom, keyboard. This tells us the user is navigating intentionally. And when I click the focus email button, program. Our application focused it programmatically. This is incredible information. We now know exactly how users are interacting with our interface, and we can create experiences tailored to their interaction style. Now, let's use this focus origin information to create our smart validation. Let's switch back to the component type script. In our subscription, I'll add the adaptive logic. First, let me create some readable constants. One for keyboard interactions and another for mouse interactions. Now here's the adaptive part. If the user focused with keyboard or mouse, we want to provide validation feedback when focus changes. Let's set show error based on whether the email is actually invalid. True for invalid, false for valid. Then, if the origin is program, meaning our application focused it, we hide any error messages. Now, I can completely remove that old onBlur method since we're handling everything in our adaptive focus monitor. Okay, that should be all we need here. Let's switch to the component HTML and remove the blur event since we don't need it anymore. Let's save and see our adaptive interface in action. First, I'll click into the field and type an invalid email. When I click outside, the error appears because this was a mouse interaction. Perfect. Now let me click back in and make it valid. Then, when I click outside, the error disappears because the email is now valid. Let me try keyboard navigation. I'll tab to the field and make it invalid again. When I tab away, the error shows up because this was a keyboard interaction. I'll shift tab back and fix the email to make it valid and tab away. The error disappears because the email is valid. Now for the moment of truth. Let me click into the field, make it invalid, and blur to show the error message. Now I'll click the Focus Email button. Watch what happens. The error message vanishes. That's our programmatic focus logic working perfectly. No more interrupting user workflows when our application is trying to be helpful. And there you have it, the Angular CDK Focus Monitor in action. This tiny but powerful service gives you incredible insight into how users interact with your UI. Think about all the possibilities this opens up. Different validation timing for keyboard versus mouse users, better accessibility for screen reader users, preventing validation spam during programmatic focus, creating more intuitive user experiences, you name it. The best part? Your users will never even notice the difference. Things will just work like they're expecting them to. The Focus Monitor is just one of many hidden gems in the Angular CDK. If you want to see more lesser-known Angular features that can level up your applications, hit that subscribe button and let me know in the comments what CDK feature you'd like me to cover next. Until next time, thanks for watching.